Dear friends, good evening. Today I would like to do one important video on behalf of this auspicious day, Guru Purnima. First of all, my hearty wishes to everyone on Guru Purnima. So I would like to talk about the planet Guru, Jupiter, on this auspicious day. Why? Because if you look at anybody's chart, out of all the nine planets, the only guiding soul is Jupiter, which is Guru. So Guru has the meaning, Guru has different meanings in different contexts. First of all, as per Sanskrit, because it's our divinely language, Guru means darkness, Ru means evader. So a divine person who is capable of removing darkness in our lives is a guru. For some people, like when we are very young, like our teacher is our guru, and before that, in our childhood, our parents were our gurus. And when you reach a certain stage, so you find different personalities, a guru kind of, Jupiter in kind of personalities. You may find, boss as guru at your work. You may find your neighbor who is a guide for you, and a sports coach for a sportsman can be a guru. So guru has different meanings, but I am talking about the core guru, a guru that gives you a divinely wisdom, that shows you a true path, that a person, a force that nurtures you, nourishes you. So what is Guru Purnima? So Guru Purnima, Jupiter. Purnima means moon. So it's a combination of Jupiter and moon energy. So Jupiter is exalted in Cancer. Who rules Cancer? Cancer is ruled by moon. Why Jupiter gets exalted in Cancer? There is a logic behind that. Because Cancer sign is a natural fourth house from Aries, which is from Kala Chakra at a mundane level. So what is fourth house? Fourth house is the first thing that comes to your mind is mother. So Guru is a motherly person. And this Cancer sign has a special star, which is called Pushyami. The meaning of Pushya is nourishing. So that's why Jupiter gets exalted in Pushya Nakshatra in Cancer sign. Because Guru is of a motherly nature who always cares, nourishes, nurtures you, guides you, shows you true path. So that's the portfolio of Jupiter. Now, coming to individual charts, irrespective of your ascendant, your lagna, irrespective of where Jupiter is placed, the house in which Jupiter is positioned is said to be very auspicious. That house usually can't bring any nonsenses, any issues, it can't mess up your life. Any house it is placed, Jupiter doesn't harm that house nor create problems related to that house, unless you do something wrong or a sin against a guru. If anyone experiences Guru Mahadasha, a Jupiter Mahadasha, as a bad phase, it means he is devoid of Guru energy, a Jupiter energy. So Jupiter in Cancer, he gets exalted, and he basically maintains high dignity there. So that's why people who have Jupiter in Kendra, Jupiter either in first house, either in fifth house, either in fourth house, either in tenth house, they actually have this kind of Jupiter personality. whether they know it or not, but that's the fact. If a person has Jupiter in their ascendant, he becomes a of noble and highly ethical quality. He doesn't give up his ethics, and he puts lot of weight, because Jupiter is a heavy planet. When Jupiter transits your moon sign or he is in ascendant, the person is supposed to be plumpy. In transit, when Jupiter moves to your moon sign, so you put lot of weight, because Jupiter develops lot of appetite, because he's karka for taste also. Whatever you eat, whether it is sweet or sandwich, ghee, whatever you eat, the essence of what you feel, the taste, that is actually given by Jupiter. So Jupiter in seventh house makes your partner a guru kind of personality. If you have a person has Jupiter in seventh house, so his partner becomes minister, a great advisory, and it is important you need to consider that advisory. Definitely the person, your partner, is of higher knowledge, not necessarily spiritual, but that person has seen a bigger aspect of life than you have seen. If Jupiter is in fifth house, that makes a person very religious, systematic. If Jupiter is in ninth house, he becomes a real guru wherever he is, whether he is at work, whether he is at sports, or whether he is at spiritual side, or whether he is at leading a mass, he becomes a higher authority, a person of higher divine knowledge. A Jupiter in 10th house, it won't give all of sudden results, but over a period of time, this person attains name, fame, recognition, and gradual improvement in business or career. Jupiter in 12th house. So 12th house is the deeds that you do, charity, self-sacrifice. Jupiter actually does well in 12th house, because Jupiter is a planet of spirituality, self-sacrifice, and doing good deeds and all. So some aspects of 12th house, they actually flourish because of Jupiter in 12th house. When Jupiter is in second house, this person has very powerful communication, the speech, it is very impressive. He has good eyes, and he maintains very good diet habits. And we can say this person has a guru kind of person in his family. It could be his father, grandfather, siblings, whatever it is. And Jupiter is in fourth house. Jupiter in Kendra actually really does well. So this person has a very good home, and he enjoys being at home. He would like to expand his home, renovate it. So Jupiter is a special planet who always helps the mankind from any kind of suffering because of his aspect, his position. So it is very important that a person to run a Jupiter Mahadasha at right point of time in their life to reach, you know, higher levels with respect to learning, acquiring knowledge, divine wisdom. And Jupiter in 11th house, in usually like any planet, they do well in 11th house. So Jupiter also works well in 11th house, but the problem here is, so Jupiter is always a giver, he is not a taker. So 11th house is a house of a house where you see fulfillment of your desires. So we can't expect a person like a guru to count on, you know, the money he has made, the riches, you know, he has acquired, the assets he has acquired. So he is not very comfortable in 11th house. So that's why it is one of the malefic houses. It is known as one of the malefic houses. And Jupiter is in 3rd house. He becomes a very good writer, artist, journalist. Jupiter also stands for law. This person fights for a community. And Jupiter is in 8th house. That position makes a person very skilled, possess various types of skills, knowledge, extraordinary knowledge. But the problem here is 8th house Jupiter produces Guru Dosha. So this person has some debt that he has to pay back his guru from his past life. And Jupiter in 6th house, usually malefics do well in 6th house, but Jupiter has a special here, because 6th house stands for debts, diseases and enemies. So Jupiter reduces the malefic nature of that particular house. So a person who has Jupiter in 6th house is known as Ajatasatru. Ajatasatru means he doesn't have any enemies, because Jupiter is not a fighter, he is a peacemaker. So there are many kinds of people in this world. Some people are driven by some motivation for them to be successful in a particular area. If a person's motivation is to gain honor, respect, to be in top position, then he is a sun ruled person. If a person just is a volatile and he just goes by what he thinks, then he is a moon ruled person. If a person is a good fighter, a good athlete, then he is a Mars driven person. If a person's motivation for doing anything is pleasure, happiness, relationships, then it's a Venus driven person. And if a person is very strict and he leads a principled life, then he is a Saturn driven person. And if a person's motivation is more of intelligence, research and thinking ability, thought process, then he is a Mercury driven person. But in case of Jupiter, the person is driven by ideals. A Jupiterian person, he possesses high ideals. There are two things that motivates one in life to lead a systematic life. One is principles, the other is ideals. Saturn is a person who imposes restrictions and principles. And Jupiter, he's beyond principles. And Jupiter's theory is always based on ideals. So the ideal in the sense, so I give you one example. So Guru is a person who never hurts anyone. That's an ideal. A principle based person, he has a different dealing. With a good person, he's a good, and with a bad person, he's worst. So that's what, you know, the Saturn's characteristic is. But whereas Jupiter, he's an ideal based person. So you can see many gurus that accept any person as their student, respective of caste, community, religion. Unless a guru possesses that ideals, those ideals, he can't do that. So this is all my analysis about Jupiter. So if you like my video, please press that like button and subscribe to my video. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Happy Guru Purnima.